Good evening, Nana here. And then in this record, I'm going to show you about the dropship process. So the dropship, what happens is that order management comes with two licenses. One is with the GOP and then one is without GOP. One of my students told me that his customer is now having a order management license without GOP. So in which case, whatever, he was unable to do any back-to-back ordering at all. So no back-to-back buy, no back-to-back make, and then no back-to-back transfers. Then nothing is possible for him. So in the dropship process, it is now asking you to set the sourcing rules as well as assignment sets. So I had a doubt that whether if you don't have a GOP license, whether you'll be in a position to configure the sourcing rules and assignment set or not. I'm not sure about it. So I made a small R&D and then I bypassed the sourcing rules and assignment sets, and then I succeeded in making dropship. So I'm going to show it to you. And then if it allows, it's okay. Well, fine. I will be making two records now. And the first record is what? The GOP without, the dropship without GOP. And then I will now make one more record on dropship with GOP now. So whichever way it's working, what happens, you can use it now. Fine. You go, this is working. And so what happens, you can just very well verify this. So let me go on and start to share my screen. I'm not sure. So go there. So, okay. I'll go there. And then I'm signing. So let me sign in now. You're logging in now. So before you start the dropship process, the basic setups has to be completed now. Click on it. Go there. I will now go to the setup and maintenance. I will now choose the procurement offering here now. Procurement offering. And then I will now go to the actions and then go to the what happens, change feature selection on the procurement. Click on change feature selection on the procurement. I'm in FSM area. So from there, so here you can now see this one. Customer sales order fulfillment must be enabled for a dropship on the procurement. So it's already enabled now. Fine. Customer sales order fulfillment is enabled. Fine. Click on done. Fine. That's the first setup. And then afterwards, I will now go to the order management area. Click on done and then come out of it now. Choose the order management area. Go to the order management area. So again, go to the actions and then go to the change feature selection now. Here, dropship must be enabled actually. So dropship is enabled. So these are two basic setups which are required on the procurement front as well as an order management front. And then the third setup is you go there. So dropship financial flows must be done properly. You go there. So manage percentage drop percentage ship percentage manage dropship financial flows. As we said, I will now go and search for it. I've already made one thing. This is for the dropship financial flows. Select and then click on edit. I'm working on the D01 authorization. Editing the record may affect today on the okay, fine, click on okay, now doesn't matter. So I'm editing it actually, fine. So I should not edit it actually, fine. Click on, I will not try to see this now, fine. Click on it, open it up and then have a look at it. So don't edit it and then click on the hyperlink and then have a look at it. So this is what happens, the supplier ownership changes once when ASN is recorded. Advanced shipment notice is recorded, but the ownership has changed. And so what are the selling BUs coming? So here, the both the selling and then the receiving BUs are same now. Right? If they are going to be different, we have to set up the intercompany payables and receivables also in financial section. So this relationship is not done. So once when you record the ASN, the material is our section. Or otherwise, the material is shipped. The sales order will be progressing to shipped upon ASN receipts. Right? Here, the process is like this now. So I'm like, I'm a Maruti car owner. One second. So I'm a Maruti car dealer and not a owner actually. I'm a dealer. And then Maruti Udyog is manufacturing the Maruti cars. So let us say I'm now going to sell it to the customer at 10 lakh rupees. And then I have only two cars. The customer is now asking for 5 cars. So what I will do is I will now sell the 2 cars which is there with the sales order. And then for the remaining 3 orders, I will now make a sales order. And then perform a drop ship. And then I will now ask my manufacturer Maruti Udyog to supply to the customer actually. So the drop ship order is now going to create a purchase order on my manufacturer. And then my manufacturer will be supplying to the customer directly, the 3 cars. But he will never bill him at all. I will only bill him. So once when the drop ship is now taken place, I will now make a billing for the customer. I will now pay Maruti Udyog for the 3 cars. at a rate of, say, let us say 6 lakh rupees. Okay. So he has now given me a 40% commission, because of which what happens, I'm only going to pay 6 lakh rupees. So this flow, I will again repeat, the customer is now placing an order for which what happens, I'm not having a sufficient stock. So for the insufficient stock, I will now create a drop ship on my manufacturer for the 3 cars. My manufacturer Maruti Udyog will now ship it to the customer directly. And then he will now send me an invoice to me through ASN or ASBN. And then I will now pay the Maruti Udyog at the rate of 6 lakhs for the 3 cars. I will now later on create what happens, the AR invoice for the customer at 10 lakh rupees. So this flow, we are going to have a look at it. So for this business process, we have seen the two basic requirements, that is on the FSM area, on the procurement side, as well as in the order management side. The third prerequisite. So the dropship financial flow is now established, fine. And then the ownership changes upon ASN actually. That means what? Once when my Maruti Udyog is now shipped to the customer, he will now send me an ASN or ASBN. And then once when you make a receipt of the ASN or ASBN, the sales order will be progressing to ship. Okay, mine is the one. So it is already active now. The status must be active. So it is already created. It will cancel. Then afterwards, you go there, you go to the manage order management parameters. Right? The third step. Now fourth setup, manage percentage. Order percentage. Para percentage entering now. So in the manage order management parameters, go there, go down. In the preparer for procurement must be set. Fine. The preparer for procurement must be set. For them, and I have already done for my this thing. Fine, my business unit is a D01 now. But D01, I have set the preparer for procurement. So if the preparer for procurement is not set, what happens? It will not be interfacing into purchasing at all. Cancel. This is not done. Fourth setup. Then I have made one BPA now. I click on done now. And I made a BPA for this particular item to automate the purchase. So go there. Go to the procurement, and then I go to the purchase orders. I made a BPA now. Now have a look at it. Come on. We'll now go to the manage agreements. I made a BPA for this now. Come on. I'll now make a search. Wait a minute. So 3000 is the one. I'll go there. Come on. And then click on the underline. Highlighted. So 3001 is a BPA. Go there. And you can now see that this is for the item. And I have now given a discount. I'll go there. Click on it. For the supplier, whatever they go there, I will know. Click on details now. I click on the details. Go down. Then you can see the one. If you buy more than 100, I'm now giving a 20% discount. So 20% discount is 0.8. So I am now given a price of what happens, a purchase price of 1 only. It doesn't matter. It will be as such. So one is the purchase price. One go there for which what happens. The Maruti Udyog, I will be, he is now giving a discount that if you go buy more than 100, what happens? 20% discount you're going to enjoy. 0.8 to be the price. So click on that and go to the orders. So I will now create a sales order also for more than 100. So that what happens, you must see whether when you interface it to purchasing and then send it to the Maruti Udyog, he will be giving me this discount also. So I click on that. There is a released amount of 3 is coming. I have already tested it actually. So click on that. So then what happens. And then afterwards, you have to go and then set up the configure procurement business function for automation actually. So click on it, go there. So then go to the setup and maintenance. Click on it, and then go there. Go to the search. Configure procurement business function is the one. Configure procurement business function. If you go there and then have a look at it. So I am now setting it up for automation. And go there, click on it. So I'm now using the D01 now. D01 business function. Okay now. So we have to have the buyer in this place. So the buyer has to be either on the item or on this place or buyer assignments. In one of the 3 places, the buyer has to be there. So then only what happens, the automation will not take place. And then I have enabled this automatic generate orders also. This tick mark also is there. If these 2 things are there, what happens? The moment the requisition comes and then hits the purchasing, it will automatically create a PO now. Because BPA is there, the buyer is there, and then the auto generate is also. So everything is now fully set for automation now. Fine. So click on cancel. So the entire setups are now complete. Fine. Go there, click on it. I will now create what happens, the sales order first. That is for the item 15D0115. So click on order management and then go to the order management. So click on create order. I'm now going to create an order. D01. I will not put the customer over here now. I will not populate the item over here. D0115. So now if you go for, let us say, 6 or 5 or 6 quantities, then click on add now. I'm adding it. I go to the warehouse area, I go to the shipment details, I go there, and then I go to the supply, and then I'm not going to give a warehouse over here. I'm not populating the supply over here. G01. I will not populate the supply over here. And then supply side, I'm populating it. So no, if you populate the supply on the supply side, it has to go for a drop ship. But the system expects me to configure the sourcing rules as well as assignment system. So I still have a doubt whether the customer who is not having a GOP license, whether he can do it or not. Because back-to-back ordering, he cannot do. But this setups, I don't know whether he can do it or not. If he can do it, it's well and good. I will be demonstrating that part in with the GOP now, right? Dropship with GOP. So here, I have done a small R&D and then I found out a way around for this. So if you are, because since I don't have a customer now, who is not having it, because I'm now working on a vision instance, and so vision instance is now configured for everything. So I'll not show you the problem here. So the supplier and supply set is not given. Warehouse is not given. It's a dropship order. Thank you for submit now. So the order is getting submitted. Now, if you go and then have a look at the fulfillment flow, fine. I'm now working on the DOO order flow generic process. Click on it now. So 900-902-8 is the one. Click on it. And then you go to the actions and then switch to fulfillment flow. And then you click on the fulfillment lines and then have all that. Go further now. So click on the do number and then have a look at it. Now you can see DOO order flow generic fulfillment process is now fired. And then it is now started. And then the error message is already come. You click on it and then you cannot see the error message. So if you go and then click on the second line, what happens? It says very clearly, attribute supplier ID has invalid value. This is mainly because when you refer the meta link for this particular one, it says that what happens, you have to have the your sourcing rules as well as assignment sets properly set in. But still, I have a doubt that whether the non-GOP license will be having it now. Fine. I made R&D and then I found out a workaround for this one. So what I did, I will tell you. So if I go and then do with what happens, bypass the schedule now. Fine. I click on done now. The reservation is getting stuck. I'll tell you how I done now. I have now made one more workflow, one more do now with the bypassing the scheduling now. I click on create now. I don't know. Because the scheduling was giving a problem. Fine. I click on it. I will not again do it now. Populate the item D0115 and then go tap now. And then I will not drop down. I will not choose what no schedule. So scheduling, I'm not going to bypass. Scheduling is now getting bypassed. I'm going to space. I will not add it now. Click on it now. So in this place, what happens? You go there, click on it. So here, if you put the supplier over here now, D01, sub one, and then the site one. Drop it down and then choose the site now. And then if you submit this order, so scheduling is bypassed, fine, but it is not getting stuck on the reservation actually. That is the problem. So go there, click on it. So it was not able to schedule because the great scheduling was a problem basically. And what are the actions? And then here, switch to fulfillment view. There only it shows that the supplier has got ID. And here also, whatever they are getting a problem. I click on it and then have a look at it now. The scheduling is bypassed. But it has got struck on the reservation actually. Reservation. So I thought that what happens is scheduling, if you bypass it, it won't do. So then what I did is I bypassed the reservation also. Then it worked perfectly. So scheduling and reservation, I bypassed. And here is a one. If you go on and have a look at this do, what happens? It is now running on my do now. I customized the do. I made it now. So it is a Nana's do. Fine. And then I made it, and then what happens? The scheduling is bypassed, reservation is not happening. So I made another do where what happens? Both the scheduling and reservations are now bypassed. I will not tell you about how to do it now, but in fact, what happens? It's already done. So I'm just going to demonstrate you how to bypass the scheduling and reservation from the do. So click on it, and then go there. Go to the setup and maintenance. Click on it, and then here, click on search now. So it's manage. Process definition. Definition. So manage orchestration process definitions. I'm going to do that. So let me query the DOO now. The standard process I'm going to query. I'm querying it now. Is the one. Right. This only fires whenever you are being a CSO. Get out of there, don't go there, I don't go to actions, don't go to duplicate. I've already done it, but I'm just showing it about how to do a new one now. I'm duplicating it. I go there and duplicate it. So here you have to remove those things now with the copy. I can remove it. It has to begin with the what happens, the custom DO only. And then afterwards, what happens? I made it as what? I made it as what? No schedule. No scheduling and no reservation. Fine. Well, take copy of it now. And that put down space. In the process display name. Now, scheduling a reservation, I had to remove it from the step section. Go there. So the 100th step is schedule. Fine. Go there. I will not delete it. Select it and then click on delete. I'm not going to ask a question whether you want to really delete or not. Fine. So it's not fine. Click on yes. I'm not deleting it. And then afterwards go down. And then here at the bottom, there is no other scheduling activities there. Everything is invoice. And then afterwards, what happens? I go to the status condition. Click on the status condition. So in the status condition, 100th is schedule, fine, go there, click on it, or not delete it. So click on yes. And then go down. You cannot see on the bottom is there anything is there or not. Click on it. Go down. So we have got what manual scheduling is there, and then manual reservation is there. So select it and then delete it. I have to delete the reservation also in the main one. Finally, let me go on and delete the reservation also. And then go down. And then in the manual reservation also, I'm going to delete it. Delete this. And then in the main one, the reservation also has to be deleted. Fine, go there, click on it. So after having deleted the schedule, what happens? They go there in the main one, here delete the reservation also. So create reservation is the one, I click on it, and then I will not go there, and then I will not delete it. Create reservation. Or what you can do is in the create reservation, you know how to delete now, right? So you can even go there, and then in the create reservation, you can even make it as a delete reservation. Delete reservation. So cancel reservation. If you do it, whatever the reservation is not applicable for it, you know, say. So, but I think I have deleted it. Fine. You can even do this. This will not say that reservation is not applicable at all. That way you can do it. So, but I think I have deleted. You can even try it the other way. Fine. We give a cancel reservation, so it will not work. So in the ship one, and then here, what happens? You done it. So scheduling and reservation has been removed. In the status condition also, I have now removed. What happens? The scheduling has been, no, see the reservation anything is there. I don't see only this scheduling, and go down. If there is any reservation coming in, what happens? Will not remove it also. So I'm not able to see. You just make a check now. Fine. Well, I don't know because I've already made it now, and I'm going to make it fast basically. So if there is any reserved is coming, and click on it. Reserve is coming. Click on it to delete. Anything on the reservation also removed. Afterwards, what happens? You go to the fulfillment line status. Having reworked all the scheduling and reservation, fine. You go there. Go to the fulfillment line status. In this place, you click on the edit status rule set. You go to the full status condition and then click on the edit rule set. I'm going to edit it now. Click on this one. You're going to save it. This is what it's saying. Fine. Click on save. Ready to save it now. So go there. And then the scheduling here, what happens? You delete it now. And then you'll now see for the reservation now. Go down. So reservation is not visible in here now. So go there. Reserved is coming. Fine. Click on it. Select that reservation. So and then you go there. Click on it. And then delete it. Go down and then see anything on the schedule. So unscheduled is there, manually removed. Likewise, make a clear manual schedule is also there. That also removed. So manual schedule, manual reservation, and then unscheduled. Fine, you have to delete all the things. All the things. So this is on the deletion. Afterwards, what happens? You have to give a save. Give a save, and then you come out of it. Save and save and close. I'm not done fully because what happens? I have already created it actually. Save and close. Then afterwards, what happens? You go to actions and then you're going to what? Validate it. Validate. So let me have what happens? One more different number because I've already created the same name. Now I'm going to click on it. I'm going to make it as well. Give a save. So it's now saved. With it. I already created one more thing. So afterwards, what happens? You go to actions and then go to validate. You go to validate. So this process is now getting validated. It's now giving a lot of errors because something is not deleted actually. Otherwise, what happens? You'll not be getting error. So after not fully deleted it. And then after validation, what happens? You go there and then click on release. You're going to release it. And then after releasing it, what happens? You're going to deploy it. With which, what happens? The custom DOO is already created. We'll cancel. So we'll now have a look at it. Now I've already created the custom DOO. Custom DOO with the no schedule and no reservation. So I have created this custom DO. This is the reservation one. Now find this is the one correct. This is the one I created. We go there and then click on it. You can find custom DO. No shielding reservation I created is already released actually. So if you cover over it now, I can see it there. So the scheduling is gone now in the main area. And then afterwards, if you go on and have a look at this, you go to the site definitions and then have a look at it. So it is not beginning, the scheduling of reservation is gone. It is not beginning only with the conditions. So likewise, what happens in the narrative. And the step also, what happens, all the things, the manual things, everything is gone now. Click on the step condition now. So here in the step condition, I'm showing everything. The bottom, here we now deleted everything. The manual scheduling manages everything at the level. So this is the way I did it. Afterwards, what I did is, I will now go to the manage order lookups now. What are the more automatic? And then I will now query for one ORA DOO order. This lookup is going to find out. For a DOO. Go there. So this is called ORA DOO order type, in which I have now created one more transaction type called what? No scheduling and no reservation. This one I did. I initially created a schedule and then it didn't work. Reservation also I created didn't work. So I'm now creating another one for no scheduling and no reservation. Actually, everything is a component by a do, a customized do actually. It's not that. So I have with the plus, I have inserted it. Now I will now make a sales order. Click on done now. So I'm now going to make a sales order. So all the setups are now complete. Let's run it. So let me go on and make a sales order. So go there, click on order management. And then you go to the order manager. And then let me get the sales order with my customized do. Click on create order. Is the D011. So the item is 15th item. D0115 is the item. I will now go for more than 100. So that what happens, I will be getting a discount also when I am buying it actually. 102. Thank you on add. So the line is added. I go to the shipment area. Click on it. And then I go to the supply. And then I will know. Before that, what happens? I will now drop down the order type and then make it as what? No scheduling and no reservation. This is the one. Which what happens? We're going to go there. Supplier, let me populate. If you put the warehouse, it is a normal shipping. If you go there, it is a drop shipping. D01. And then the number is. Click on it. And then have a look at it. Site. Not done. So this is all populated. And go there. Click on submit. So click on submit. Which what happens? The order will be getting submitted. So the order number will be created, fine. 9009, 900, 9030 is the one, fine. This will not have any problem at all because both the scheduling and reservations have been bypassed. Right. And then go to the switch to the menu. And go there. And then I will now click on the order number. Click on the orchestration process. Definition, you know, see the orchestration plan. You know where to go. Procure and then invoice only. Nothing else is there. You know, automatically procurement has started. So no scheduling, no reservation, nothing. Fine, go there. It goes to procurement direct. Because both the scheduling and reservation have been bypassed. And then the conditional one on the do has automatically sensed that what happens, it has to be a dropship order and the procurement has started. So the started now is now started. See, you now saying requisition is now created. And go to the fulfillment line and then have a look at it. The fulfillment line, go there. And then have a look at the supply state. And supply is if you go and have a look at it. You know, see. The requisition number is created. Since I have automated the PO process also with the BPA and then with the buyer and then automatic sourcing, the dropship PO also will be coming very soon. So go there. I will now refresh it again. So once when the dropship PO comes in, what happens? The status will be going from requisition created to awaiting shipping action. So it will be going to awaiting shipping action. Right. It will now go on to the awaiting shipping. That means what the purchase order is also created and go down and then have a look at the purchase order. So 2000 is the purchase order. So we'll now go to the what's called purchasing. Duplicate it and then go there and then have a look at the 2006 purchase order. So click on the procurement and then go to the purchase orders. Let me query the purchase order. Click on it and then go there. Go to the manage orders now. 2006 is the order and go to have a look at it now. Click on search. So once when you search for it, it will show you fine. You click on the order number now. Fine, click on it. If you click on the hyperlink, what happens? We are not editing, you are only viewing it actually. So click on it. There's no coming fine with that on it. So the line is now coming out there, the schedules and then distributions, everything else. So it's now having one intimation fine with a click on it. Information is there, fine, click on information. The schedule, there is information. Scheduled goods are for to be shipped to a third party. Fine, it is not for us. So it's a drop ship one. So it is not showing you that it has been shipped to a third party. So if you go on and see the address to where we have to ship it, now fine, with a click on it on the main line, and with a click on the lines, it will be the customer's address. So it is a customer's address. Shipping method, fine, OB destination. And then it is now saying D01 custom one is the one. If I click on this icon, it will show you whatever. It will be there. So this is the place where you get shipped. So 01 customer score one is the customer. So to whom, what happens, you wait now. So this is the third party location actually. It's not our location. So the supplier is supplying to the third party location. And then here, if you try to edit, I don't think it will allow you to edit actually. Man. It will be freezed actually because it is again a third party. So it's not showing all this information now. So you know, request for delivery, the third party location. The location is not showing. You see, this is a customer address. So the tire highest is around. Fine, around. If you click on the location, now see whether you can able to see the location or the customer. Fine, it's not showing you the customer. Customer address, and then what happens? One Manhattan, New York, and then all the things that you can even see on this place. So on the manager orders, if you go there, and the customer's address can be seen. Click on done, and then come out of it now. So the supplier has to supply to the customer's address. So the address. Customer address is what? One Manhattan, New York, and then that is now getting reflected on the purchase order. Click on it. So the purchase order is now reflecting the address. So this is where it gets. Now we are going to record a AS and purchase. I will now be recording a ASB and a such, not a ASM. Let me record a ASBM. So once when you record a ASBM, what happens? The status of the sales order will be progressing to what? Ship lecture. Once the ASBM is recorded, you know, awaiting shipping, go there and then click on it, click on done, and then record the ASBM. And 2006 is the purchase order, fine, go there, click on it, and then you go to the supply chain execution, and then go to the inventory management, and then you know, go to the reserves, and then perform a reserve. Click on it, go there, and then drop it down, and then you go to the reserves. And then click on the receipt, and then go to the create ASN or advanced shipment notice or create advanced shipment come billing notice. So I'm now getting ASBN now. And the organization is what? D011. I'm now putting the organization. So I'm now going to what? Once again, I'm going to go there, click on OK. The organization is coming. So purchase order number is 2006. Fine, go there, 2006. I'm going to tab now. And then click on search now. It will now show you there will be eligible dollars. Fine, for this, whatever, then now create ASN now. 102 is the quantity for which I'm now going to create. Fine, click on the create ASBN. So ASBN is very good. So shipment number, I will now say nana_124 now. Fine. So I'm now putting I don't know whether alphanumeric is allowed or not. I will now make it as well. 124. Shipment number is 124 now. So it was, and then I can give the flight terms over again, whatever that buyer pays flight. And then shipment method, I will now put D01 and get an popping it up. And then I will now say number of packing units here, now giving it as 4 now. The bill of lading number. So these are all value additions. They are not mandatory fields actually. And then I'm going to the packing slip number, packing code. So there are all these things you can do it. This is a ASM. Fine, this is a drop ship. So some comments you're going to give it enough. And then I will now create an invoice number also. I'm going to say invoice number is what? 1010. I'm going to put it. Invoice amount is 102 is the quantity. So there is no taxation. I'm not going to do it. Shipping cost, I don't know, say it's $2. Shipping cost. I don't know where to see the shipping cost. So in the billing information, the customer is saying 102 plus 2. So we have to pay him 104 actually. So we'll now see whether we are able to see the invoice, the tax, the shipping cost also. What else? The currency is coming, site is coming, fine, tax amount, I'm not putting it fine. Payment terms, I will not put 2 by 10, in the 30. What else? So in the invoicing, I have not done it, everything fine. Whether. So how much is doing it? Fine, 102, whatever, I go there and then populate the same 102 again. So for the entire 102, I'm now creating ASBN. Advanced shipment compelling mode is going to be great. So everything is okay, good. Fine, I will now submit it. 124 is the shipment number. So the shipment number is 124. The packing, all the things are there. So what happens, the system will be creating an ASBN actually. And I click on submit. So ASBN 124, ASBN space 124 was created. ASBN 124 is created. Now whether this is the full number or not, only 124 is the number, I'm not sure. So once when the ASBN is created, what happens, you can go there and then have a look at it. You go to the manager orders, the order will be progressing to what? Ship actually. Click on refresh now, and the order will be progressing to ship. Then it is not shipped, then what happens, the program will be running, and then what happens, it will be getting interface to that, it will be going to awaiting billing. Frankly, professional, it will go to awaiting billing. So no ship. So the program is internal running, and go to check on it. And then switch to full command view, and then have a look at it. It will have to go to awaiting billing. So it's processing, fine, go there. So in the orchestration plan, if you go on and have a look at it, fine, invoice process might have started. So the invoice process might have started. The orchestration plan, and then how about it? So the invoice process might have started. Like invoice has started. So once when it is completed, what happens? It will now progress to what? Awaiting billing. It is now shipped, now showing. So we have to wait for some time. In the meantime, what happens? You can go there and have a look at the fulfillment lines. And then the fulfillment lines, we go to the supply details, you can now see the buyer, everything is coming. Fine. So whether the ASBN is recorded here or not. So the ASBN is not recorded here. So drop ship schedule, PO number line, everything is now coming here now. But the requisition number is coming as well as the PO number is coming, but the receipt status is not coming. You know, see somewhere in this place, item details. So there is no details at all. You just see whether you may be having the receipt details also somewhere, the general details for that. You know, see whether anything is coming or not. So there are so much of information has already been populated on this one. Okay, so here what happens is now got the awaiting billing. Now we'll now go there and then run the concurrent. Click on duplicate. We go to the tools and then you go to the schedule to process and then let us now run the import auto invoice for bringing it to the AR actually. Click on the schedule process. So it's the import auto invoice. The tab. So click on search command now coming and click on import auto invoice. So click on OK. So go there, DO. And then what is the number of this order? 900-9030. Go there, put in the monitor process. And now put this transaction source is due now. And then go down. And then I will put the sales order number. Go 900-9030. Go tap. And then I do the run. So click on it. Then submit it. Very important. So this is now running. My import order invoice is now running. So upon completion, what happens? It will be sending a notification to the feeder system. The feeder system is order management. So that will be communicating back to that. What happens? It will be getting done. The notification system is now running. So once when this completed, what happens? The system will be, the base system will be notified now. So in the meantime, what happens? I can go to the receivables and have a look at the AR invoice. Click on it. Go there. So I will now go to the receivables. Receivables and then go to the billing now. And then let us now query. So we click on it and then we'll now go to the what's called manage transactions and then query the transaction. Find this 900-9030-1 and then source is what in EBIS. What you do is we will now put whatever the reference number as the order number and the date normally. So here is a distributed order orchestration. Click on that. Do is now given as a source. At the 900-9030, make a search, it will now show you the invoice being created. Click on it. You can now see for the one or two quantities, whatever the price is one, and then you know, if you give taxes and other things, whatever the everything will be coming over here now. So you can even view the invoice over here. Click on the image, view image, and then you can have a look at the image. Invoice image can be seen now. So this will be configured by the technical team in appropriate manner now. They'll be putting the company logo and then the company name and something, whatever they want, no? Their mission statement also, whatever is there, go there. And then you now go there and can see that the total billing actually, and the line total is there. And then where they have to send the payments and all. So this actually, this sheet will be basically customized by the technical, and then that will be printed as such. So the invoice is now created, and go there, click on it now. And then if you go there, the line status will be closed. Billing is now completed, and click on it. So once when you complete all the activities, the point on the line still is not closed. So the main screen also will be done. Or not. Fine. So by which, what happened? The drop ship process is now completed. Click on again, what happens? Close. Click on done and then come out with the main one. The main screen, what happens? Is closed. Now let us go there and then what happens? Try to push it to the, what happens? AP for paying the supplier. Actually, the Maruti Udyog has been right. I will now go to the schedule new process and find the process. I will now send it. And the send pay on the zip. Send process pay on send pay on the zip. So go there, click on OK now. So the transaction source is what? ASBN. Fine, I'm not sure the ASBN or anything like that. So the receipt number is 124 now. Fine, I don't know. Go and search for it. It is 124, the receipt number. Let's search it. Is the ASBN 124 or what? ASBN. I don't make a search on it. 124. Not coming at all. Click on advance and make a search. So I don't say is not blank. Now click on search. I will now do one thing. I will now add the field and then I will now add the organization name also over there now. So organization starts with, you say it's a D01 and then you tap it. Drop it down and then choose it now. So multiple things can only click on drop it down. I'm not accepting it. Contains. D01. Click on search, multiple searches are making upload. So it is not given these receipts numbers only. But my number of 124 is not visible. Maybe I may not be able to give a receipt or not. I don't know. It is not coming. I mean, aging period is 05. I will not see whether this what happens that creates a AP invoice or not. Okay. So the send pay on receipt, I run it for ASBN actually. Click on it. If it creates it to be Excel, otherwise what happens, you have to manually create. So 2006 is the purchase order number. You don't see whether it creates or not. Same PM receipt is not running, it has got completed, but afterwards what happens, it is not done. So if you go there and then have a look at the output. Click on it. Have a look at the output. So whether it has not picked up anything for the processing or not, you have a look at it. I'm going to save it. Okay. Well, show it. And then click on the text mode. So it says what everything is coming. So the number of invoices created is zero. Koli Muttai. Fine, it's not coming at all. So nothing has been selected. Interface also, whatever, nothing is there. So that means what? The automatic pushing is not happening. Okay. So let's go there and then create a manual invoice. So invoice place. So this is not completed on this. Nothing else for us. The review transaction is the AR. Now go to the AP side and then create the 2006 one. And then I will now go there. I will now go to the procurement and I'll go to the what's called payables. I'm clicking on the payables. Then I go to the invoices now. So you go there. There are two invoices that I find. Click on it and then have a look at it. 1010 is the invoice number. Yes, it has come. So without processing, I think it has come, or I don't know. It has not come. 1010, you will not find that it comes in Excel now. So you need not have to run the send to pay on it is not required, I think. Probably. To go there, it has already come. 1010 is invoice number and go that on it. So 102 is also coming, fine. 102 is coming, but the two, the shipment charges is not coming. They are now given the freight, yeah, is now coming. So item charges this, and then the freight charge is also coming as $2, fine, because everything is coming. But then why the amount total is still 102? It must be 104, no, fine, I don't know why it's so. So at least what happens, it does not come, fine. The purchase order number, everything is coming, fine. So ship location, everything is coming. So I think probably the send to pay on receipt need not be run as such, or I don't know, I'm not very sure about it. So it looks like what happened, there is no need to run at all. So the system is automatically might have created the invoice over there. Freight charge is coming over there, fine. The total amount is 104. The due is only 102. Fine, there is a exclamation mark on this. Click on it now, let's see what is the exclamation mark. Go there, fine. I couldn't understand this. It's they say out of balance, basically. It is not saying out of balance. But in the total also, what happens, we are not getting the total amount of 104 over here. Okay, I don't know payables and so what happens, I don't know whatever. I will not try to validate it now. If I'm not validating, I'm saying the invoice action can try to validate it and see whether it gets validated or not. Or it's not getting an error. You must provide a value for the attribute liability distribution. Oh God. So this I don't know. Fine. So financials has to put the liability account over there. Otherwise, what happens, it will not be done. There is a reason that liability distribution is not done. So at least what happens, we have now pushed into payables now. Okay. So the dropship process, so the entire demonstration, what I have done is what with an assumption that they will not be able to create what happens, the sourcing rules as well as the assignment sets. Because I'm not sure about if you don't have a GOP. See, somebody please update me if we don't have a GOP, is there any better method when compared to this or not? Right? If there is a thing, then we can go by this also. Fine. But this method is also working. It. That is what I want to say. So if you have, so I will now make one more record on what happens with this dropship with the GOP, where I will be creating the sourcing rules as well as assignments that I will demonstrate to you in the next video. I hope that this session was informative for you, and then I will now try to see on the next video. Bye now. Thank you for watching.